Welcome to the Spy Collection. My name is Anastasios, and in this first episode we will look at a rare device from the United States military intelligence used also by the Central Intelligence Agency. It's an artifact from the 60s known as the Seismic Intruder Detection Device, or short for SID, and in some references the device is mentioned as the dog-dropping FM radio transmitter, Noiseless Button Bomblet, NBB, or Dog-Do Transmitter. The device was developed originally for use in the Vietnam War, but was also utilized during the Cold War. If we check the online CIA museum, we will see two versions of this device, a well-known one that we will look at in a future video, and an earlier model, the one you see on the left. Those were nickel-cadmium battery-powered seismic sensors with an embedded radio transmitter, concealed as pool-like containers. Those devices were manufactured by a variety of companies, and the one I have here, it was manufactured by CTS from Bern, Indiana in 1964. This device was came into this packaging, and if we open this up, we can see the actual device, which is really tiny. And as you can see, it has a clay-like outer layer that conceals it, making it look like a rock. Now, if we are going to weight this device, we'll see that it's also pretty lightweight. Specifically, we're talking about a device that weighs only 30 grams. And this specific version was designed to look like a rock, but there are other versions that are designed to look like other material depending on the operating environment. Generally, those devices are very, very simple radio transmitters with a vibration, also known as seismic sensor, that sends VHF radio broadcast messages, typically using Morse code, when the sensor is activated. The broadcasts are caught either by receivers in the region, within a few hundred meters, or using signal intelligence airplanes flying over the devices. A few references also describe those devices being used as homing beacons for search and rescue operations, as well as targeting beacons placed in the target's location and used to guide airstrikes. There is very limited documentation around those devices. However, there is one patent that is likely related to those devices and shows the operating switch mechanism. In this specific one, there is this tiny bit over here that you can turn it around. And depending on the position, according to the pattern you will see now, it can set the device to continuous beacon, or it can set the device to the seismic sensor, which means once vibration is detected, then the device will be activated. And as you can see here, if camera focuses, we're talking about a very tiny little switch. And moving next, we have this really nice research that was published online by Bruce Clark, and has documented a lot of different radio devices, and in this one he has also managed to find an X-ray image of the device where we can clearly see this switch that I just demonstrated, the battery compartment with three coin batteries, the transmitter and the sensor. Also below there is a reference to a 1976 book titled The Electronic Battlefield, where it is explained that those devices were typically dropped along with parachute-dropped, more powerful transmitters like the ARF buoy 3 in this case, and they were used to relay the signals from the smaller devices back to airplanes or recon forces that were close by. And also in the same page you can find the reference to the patent that it was mentioned earlier. However, the patent is not clear if it is actually for this device or not. As mentioned, this device came in different camouflage depending on the operating environment. Even nowadays, similar but far more technologically advanced devices are being deployed all around the world for the same purposes. However, nowadays we call those UGS, standing for Unattended Ground Sensor, and we might look into some of these more modern versions in a future video. For now, that was the CIA seismic sensor. Thank you for watching, and remember that in this world, nothing is as it seems.